It was hard, I think, for some of my students to wrap their brain around the fact that a Western society, people that look just like them, lived like this.
Hi, I'm Nick Gillespie, and today we're talking with Jim Abbott about his new exhibition in Philadelphia for the Philadelphia International Festival of the Arts. It's called Berlin, Landscape of Memory. We're in a room filled with photographs from Berlin from before the wall went down in the late 80s to 2012. Talk a little bit about the wall, and obviously it separated the city, it separated east from west, free from totalitarian. How did people, on the west at least, how did they transform the wall?
It was a vehicle for communication, but then you also had artists that came that sort of did projects on the wall, drew attention to it.
Yeah, and you've talked about when people tried to do something aesthetically pleasing on the wall, people would draw a white line.
There was literally a white line to just with a big brush that would go all the way through it, and I was told that that was to negate the aesthetic nature of the wall.
So, and, I mean, that was a way of saying, don't turn this into an art object.
Right.
There's nothing beautiful or artistic about this.
Right, and we take this more seriously than you. Yeah. But there was a quasi-acceptance of it in everyday life. There had been so many accommodations between East and West so that the cities could function that it was just bizarre.
How do Berliners remember the wall?
Well, it's interesting because there was that whole series of news reports a week and a half ago about parts of the East Side Gallery that they're now removing for development, and that was where the pictures of the beach club were taken. It was clear to me in listening to the activists that had shown up that to some people now, they want what's there. They don't want any more of it to disappear.
What's the motivation there? Is that they don't, you know, they don't want to lose the past and the horror of the past, or they don't want to see things change as a kind of concession to capitalism or free enterprise?
Well, those neighborhoods have always been probably the most anti-capitalist of West Berlin. There is a population in Berlin that wants the reminder. And the thing about the East Side Gallery was that was a place that became a tourist site and a reminder. It wasn't a planned place. In other words, there are now all these strategic places you can go and learn all about the wall, and they've rebuilt it in places, and they have museums, and they mark the sidewalks and so on. But this was something that kind of grew out of the people to begin with.
How do Berliners remember communism and the GDR?
What I found amusing was enough time has passed that there was a sense of humor about a lot of it. Like, you can go to Berlin now and you can rent a tour of Berlin in a two-cycle Trabant, which was their car, one of two cars you could own, and you see strings of 12 of them driving through Berlin with a tour guide. There's a large building that had been a GDR apartment house that has been converted into a hotel near the train station, where everything in it is GDR. So there's this
even
odd...
the listing devices.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
But what's the message of looking at Berlin before the wall was pulled down and now after years on?
It's remarkable to think that it was a bloodless revolution. I mean, that in this day and age is extraordinary. Two, the wall was really a culmination of decades of German history, if not 100 years. It was so absolute in its kind of metaphor of the differences, and it was where the two systems met. So one, it was illustrative. To me, here are two ideologies represented in cement. If you want to debate the ideologies, look at the differences here.
Some people would say, look, we're at a terrible economy now, and you know, capitalism has failed. What's the value of remembering that kind of, you know, true head-to-head clash between a kind of free enterprise system or a capitalist system and a communist system?
It was interesting. I brought my class down to see the show, and some of the questions I got surprised me because they had no idea that there could be a society like the GDR where travel was forbidden. You know, you weren't going to travel. Your relatives lived 150 yards from you, and you were not going to see them. It was hard, I think, for some of my students to wrap their brain around the fact that a Western society, people that look just like them, lived like this. And it was not that long ago.
We've been talking with Jim Abbott. His new exhibition is Berlin Landscape of Memory. It's part of the Philadelphia International Fine Arts Festival. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you.